podcast listeners. Welcome to the show number 617. My name is Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. We're back in the studio.
We didn't forget about you.
You may thought we have, but we've been doing video. We've been doing Inside Xbox. Laura's here. Hi, Laura.
Hello.
It's nice to have the gang is back.
Yeah.
It's just the three of us, and we don't have any special guests. We're just doing a nice, you know, kind of old school show here.
That's right. I'm glad to be back.
Yeah.
In front of a microphone, not in front of a camera.
In front of a camera, which people enjoy. But we're not, we're in your ears and not in your face and your ears.
Yeah, so stop looking around. Like, where are they? I hear their voice. I know they're here somewhere.
We are. We're right here.
It's just this.
The most surprising thing when we do these mixer video podcasts, do you know what it is, Laura?
What is the most surprising thing?
The number of people who are like, that's what Jeff looks like?
Why does that keep happening? What do you all think?
I've known you for a long time, and I don't know. It's just people have this mental image of you.
But yeah. What is that image? That's the thing. Is real life better or worse? And it seems really unclear.
Surely there is an artist out there that has this impression of you. Maybe that artist could draw what they think you look like.
That
you
know, it's gonna like look such a bad
it's gonna look, it's gonna look like one of those weird midway caricatures.
Oh my god!
Send us your pictures.
Don't.
What?
No.
Send us your pictures of the show.
What does Jeff supposed to look like?
Yeah,
what do you think his voice means?
What is it
translated into a picture?
Yeah, there was even like there was a YouTube comment, and it just said he does not look like what I expected. It's very disturbing, and I'm like,
oh, I didn't see that one.
Oh. I did because I sent it to the show producer, and I'm like, if you don't want me back in episode two, I understand.
Speaking of that, we did an episode of Inside Xbox. We brought it back, which is a it's now back as a monthly live show. Laura, it used to be a pre-recorded show, we have This Week on Xbox and we have Inside Xbox. The difference is simple. This Week on Xbox is like the news show. And Inside Xbox is like, you know, 20 or 60 minutes. It's a news magazine.
Nobody knows what that means.
It's
too many numbers.
It's a news magazine, meaning we're going more in depth than we
no
did
No one
that.
Knows what that means either, Larry. No one gets magazines
It means you. It means you talk with the music guy
All right, here, you want to know what it means? It means I have parrots, okay?
Yeah.
It means I have parrots, although they weren't parrots.
Macaws.
No, they weren't even macaws. Somebody corrected me. They're apparently a type of bird from Brazil.
Oh.
So I didn't know that either. So I apologize to all the ornithologists.
They were very intelligent. They could do a lot of things.
They actually commented to me that you didn't look anything like you sound.
They did. The bird said that too. Who's that?
They actually, we had a good time. So we did Inside Xbox last week, Saturday. You came by the set,
I
Laura.
Did.
So good to see you.
I stopped by. Thanks
yeah, you,
for inviting
you're like,
me.
You're like, hey, let's come by. So we did that live on Saturday. Jeff and I were there, and we had Ricari and Graham, who's of course been on the show. We had Alex. We had quite a gang there. It was a lot of fun, wasn't it?
We actually had a really good time. Like, if you have to work on a Saturday, y'all are the people I want to have to work
with. It was a ton of fun, and we got some great feedback. We gave some stuff away, and we're going to do it again next month. I don't know when it is next month. I don't know what we're talking about next month, but we're doing a show next month. That's the good news, Laura.
Good for that good news.
Do you want the bad news?
What is the bad news?
The bad news is, unfortunately, speaking of next month, we will not be doing a podcast at PAX East this year.
It just
did not work out, so I apologize. I will be there. I'll be on site. Jeff, you'll be on site. Laura, you're not going
to
join us this year,
unfortunately. Not, no.
But we couldn't do a podcast. It didn't come together this year, but don't worry about it. We'll be there. Jeff and
it's always Prime, right?
There's always what? Yes.
PAX West.
When you said Prime, I was like, we're on Amazon Prime now? I don't know what I was thinking.
I thought it was a restaurant.
You didn't realize that?
Yeah, I was like, we'll be in your ears in 2 days or less. Free shipping.
Yes.
So anyway, so that's a little programming note along that. And then we got some other programming notes coming up, but we'll talk about those.
Do you know when your next Inside Xbox is going to be?
We just know it's next month. They haven't told Jeff. I think it's got to be before the 14th or 15th because I'm headed out. I'm going to be taking holiday for
And there's no show without you.
There is, but you guys.
It's not a good one.
No, that's not true.
It's Inside Xbox. That pause, you know, is just great.
I expected
to be longer and longer.
Could you hear me working on the pause when you were back? Because you were behind me.
Yeah.
Do you remember that dramatic open, Laura,
yes,
with
I
the
do.
Thing in the hole?
Do, 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 do.
Well, I'll tell you the funny, behind the scenes story of that is, so we get into our positions, we do the show open, you know, Jeff does his beat Graham, and then Jeff, and then Alex, and Ricari. And they have to come to me. I'm standing at the front of the stage. If you go back and watch tape, I have to step in front of the camera. The lights turn on, and then the boom, the crane is in my front, and then it pulls away. So it does everything to frighten the hell out of not one bird, but two birds.
You have two birds on your shoulder,
right? And they're like, "Wait a minute, the lights just went on. Wait a minute, the camera's moving. What's going on?" They kind of panicked a little, but then they settled down.
It could have went awry many ways, but did not.
They did tell me the parrot lady, and that is her name.
Yes.
Dot com.
The parrot lady.
I saw her van.
Yes.
The parrot lady.
Theparrotlady.com. She, the pirate wrangler, she was very nice. She told me that, you know, because we're talking about Sea of Thieves and pirates, that's why pirates have eye patches. Because apparently the parrots would, or the birds, the macaws, or the Brazilian, would peck the parrots, the pirate's eyes out.
Oh, goodness.
So they called that one on your right shoulder, the Widowmaker.
I had one. Oh, my gosh. I had one on each, so I could have been dead, but it
no,
wasn't.
No, she put it on my shoulder later.
Did you keep
and I didn't
your
like
hands
it.
Of your eyes?
I didn't know,
Laura.
I did. I'll tell you what. I did keep my hands on my nose.
They smell great.
They were not a. They did not smell.
Oh, really?
They smelled like the wrong part of the
it's
jungle.
It's an animal.
Oh no.
Yeah. So it's an animal, precisely. All right. Well, we're getting along there. So Inside Xbox, that'll come up next month. We'll have you. You know, maybe we'll have you on a show, Laura.
I'd love to be.
Would
on
you
a
like
show.
To come? What would you like to do for a segment?
Yeah.
Well, I'll talk to the show producers.
I'd love to be.
They've always. I know the show producers watch our podcast and listen to this show, so they're always like, "Hey, maybe we can get Jeff on. Maybe we can get Laura on."
Yeah,
so
happy to.
I told
to
them.
Help.
I told them. I said, "Look, I'm easy. Jeff's easy. Laura's a little bit of a diva." No, that's not true.
I would at least ask for an eye patch.
Yeah, and an eye patch.
And only green M&Ms in the green room.
So anyway, let's jump into the show.
Let's do it.
Do you want to go into what we're playing? I mean, I haven't had a chance to play much of
what?
Anything lately. Well,
you've been on the road.
I was on the road. I was taking a look at the new Jurassic Park game.
Mm.
Amazing.
Which looks
it's like a park builder.
It's a
right?
sim game. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm all about that.
Oh my gosh, that sounds super.
Yeah,
cool.
We're gonna have more details on this week on Xbox later on this month. I happened to go down. I spent the day in spent a couple days down there in LA earlier this.
Oh,
week.
I was. Down there in Isla Nublar,
is exactly where I was.
Yes.
So it was a lot of fun.
Off and the coast of
we have a special we have a special guest coming up on this week on Xbox in the future. I think you can probably figure out who that is. He's going to cause chaos.
Will he I'll find a way?
He will find a way. He will find a way. So it was a delightful talk about that in the future. So yeah, I really haven't had a chance to play that much. I've been playing a little bit of Fortnite, just like a couple of friends.
Your good friend Drizzy?
Drizzy.
Yes. I saw this on Twitter last night and I had no idea what was happening.
Well, why didn't you text us? We would have explained it to you.
I had no idea. So tell me what happened.
Well, basically, so Ninja is a major streamer. He plays Fortnite and has been enjoying quite a lot of success. And I at some point over the like I think a couple of weeks ago Drake followed him on Instagram. Like everybody noticed this, and I guess they just joined and they were playing. They were running duos, and what is that sound? And then basically everyone started watching, and then like Kim.com showed up, and
wow.
Like a player from the Steelers showed up, and
it just turned into
like
this weird
rappers showed up.
This pop up event.
It was insane.
So it wasn't a scheduled thing.
It was just a thing, and it ended up.
It happened.
It was everyone was watching, and it was pretty entertaining.
Yeah, I saw Twitter explode. I was like, "What is this?" Yeah. If I knew it was going to happen, I would have. You know, tuned in because it sounds pretty entertaining.
Yeah,
I was actually on an airplane back from LA, or I would have joined as well. So, but oh well.
It was crazy. It was just one of those things.
You playing? Have you had a chance to check Fortnite out?
Oh yeah,
yeah.
I've played Battle Royale.
Do you build?
I do enjoy the building component.
Are we going to play together sometime?
We should.
Okay, because
I'm much better at this than PUBG.
You are.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm much better at PUBG than this. So
I know. Maybe
Jeff, you're the tiebreaker on this.
Yeah.
I have not played Fortnite Battle Royale. I've played a lot of PUB, but I'm happy to come in there and jump in with you.
Apparently,
I've played the original version.
Hello, fellow kids. We'll play.
Yeah, exactly. maybe Drake will show up, or maybe Young MC.
Yeah, who knows?
We're not going to get top echelon rappers joining us.
Nor do we want that.
No. Well, you know.
What are you playing, Laura, other than Fortnite? You said playing Fortnite.
I haven't had too much of a chance to play this week. It's been a busy one for me as well. But I do want to jump back into Fortnite since it looks like they've made some updates and it's been...
Oh, there are, you know, the guys at Epic. We know the guys at Epic. I've known them for years and they're doing great work down there. So they're just whatever kind of Battle Royale game, we got you covered.
Oh,
exactly.
Yeah.
So I've played both PUBG and Fortnite and they differ in a few ways. The big thing is that you can do some building in Fortnite. You can construct things around you to help you with your mission or to construct ramps to get from places to the other.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to collect materials. So it's like a little bit Minecraft-esque that you have to like break down things and collect materials so you can go build and do something else. So I really love that component of it.
There's another game you may like. Jeff and I played it.
Quite a bit. The Darwin Project.
Have you seen this?
No.
So Jeff, why don't you explain that?
Yeah. So it is a much smaller battle royale, 10 people. But I'd say the defining characteristic is it's got a live director. And so this person is observing everything that's happening and can help or hinder
players.
I'm
laughing because of what
we'll talk about that. Yeah. And so it makes it a lot more Hunger Games-y. Like there's, it's not like random, like where's the circle going to happen next, or where is the, like the red zone or something like that. It's like, no, it is deliberate. Hey, there's a bunch of people here. We're going to remove gravity in this section and then craziness happens, or we're going to drop health on that. This person was daring. We'll give them a little bit of bonus, but there's some minor crafting and you can get better shoes. Cold is a persistent thing. And over time you will get cold if you don't build fire. So you can actually craft a coat that makes that happen less often.
But if you craft a fire, does that make you more visible to others?
Yes.
To come kill
yes.
You?
Okay. So people will see the fire.
Really close to the Hunger Games, which sounds really good.
Yeah. So it's really we had a great time playing it, and then we were playing the night before it went live. We were just helping to test out the dottings of the lowercase j's and crossing of the t's, and we ended up in a game, and Larry was director, and I was in the game. And
you were the director?
Yeah, I was the director.
I won that game handily.
Well, as the director, you have this super god view, and you're able to zoom around and look at people, and you can see the whole play field, and you can decide what zones to close, what impact the game, and then you do it. You can't do everything at once. You have to build up, I think they call it action points.
Yeah.
And so at one point you can buff people. Or give them shields. So I'm like, Jeff's in a battle, I'm buffing him. Jeff's in a battle, I'm giving him a shield.
The odds were in my favor.
They were ever in your favor.
Ever in my favor, thank you.
And, so now, it tells you don't do that, so we kind of...
Yeah, we were just... Yeah, that's probably bannable in real life.
It was the name of testing.
But it was... It's really fun. It has just a different feel than any other Battle Royale game I've played. So I definitely recommend giving it a go. It's in game preview right now, and it's relatively affordable. So worth at least watching some videos on it, see if it's your speed.
For sure. How does the director win? Is there a way for...
There isn't really a director. There isn't a way for the director to win. You are, Laura.
I say you just happen to be there.
Yeah, you happen to be there, and you're part of the game flow. But there's not that I saw, but again, Jeff and I were playing some of the pre-release, so there may have been some win state that I'm unaware of.
Yeah, and it's game preview, so it will change. They'll take your feedback, and it'll get better, and they love that. The developers, they're from Montreal. Good people.
I believe that, yeah. In fact, that's right, because remember, when we were playing in your game, one of the other guys was a developer.
Yes.
Oh, that's cool.
Right. So I was buffing you, much to the chagrin of the developer.
I beat him.
I took him
down. That's right. I do remember this.
And you won the first game, so we did all right.
Yeah, we did all right. Without any extracurricular assistance.
You killed me. And so the first game I ever had, they threw up a big screen and said, Major Nelson killed you. And
bam!
Not for the last time, I'm sure.
So that was fun.
Anyway.
What else? What else are we playing, Jeffrey?
Well, my in-laws are in town, which is just phenomenal.
Oh, that's fun.
They're good people. They're just really good people. Quiet. Don't take up a lot of space.
I'm lots of time.
Being totally honest right now. Anyway, they're staying in my game room, in the room where I play all of my games. So I've been all on the laptop. But fortunately, Final Fantasy 15 Windows. I'm playing a lot of it. It came out, and so I picked that up, and I've been playing on my laptop. And you know what? It looks phenomenal. It looks really good. It's also been updated on Xbox One. It's Xbox One Enhanced. So I'm imagining it looks great there, too. I just can't. You have access to my Xbox right now. Playing a lot of City Skylines. It was something we had talked about, the Windows 10 edition of that. The Xbox One edition will be coming to Xbox Game Pass in April. Absolutely keep your eyes out for that. And I actually finally had time to sit down and play Age of Empires Definitive Edition.
That's what you were playing.
And I played a lot of it. And you know what? There's a lot of game there. It took me way back. And after like a match or two, it's a game from 1997 essentially, and sort of getting used to the mechanics of it, but after like a round, then I was like, oh, I'm like totally back into this, and I just enjoy building up the cities and advancing the tech and running around with hoplite or elephants and stomping catapults and things like it. It's a good time. And the announcer is just like so over the... You should have done some of the announcing. The announcer is very over the top. I don't know if it's the original because...
Are you implying I'm over the top?
I think that's what he was implying.
I don't think I'm implying. I think I'm pretty overtly talking about it.
I can take it a notch if you want.
But nobody wants that.
I can be wrong.
No, just do it. He does. This is Inside Xbox. I love that. I was back there. I laugh if you watch, if you see the retake.
Really?
I was laughing. I was just
chuckled. Why are you laughing at me?
No, it was so you that it was great.
Okay. This is Inside Xbox.
Nice. The pause was pregnant with octuplets.
Well, if you remember, I was deciding where to put the pause in. I was to put it at the beginning. Yeah. Anyway, it was
this is
yeah. No, because I think I say this, and then I think I look at the two parrots. And
yeah,
the
maybe
two
that
birds
that was
and,
it.
I don't know. I don't
yeah.
know. Whatever.
It was great.
Go back and watch the VODs on YouTube.com/Xbox
and Mixer and every place.
Hey, we got to do another video. We're gonna do another video podcast. Speaking of that, Laura,
we should.
Yeah.
Do we have one on the schedule?
We don't. Because
April's a bit crazy.
April's a bit crazy because we've got PAX, of which we just talked about, and then we come back, and then we do an Inside Xbox, I think, sometime, and then I'm out. So it's we'll do one in early May. I promise that'll be the next time we do it because it's tough to think about May when we're in March. But
that's true.
We got to do. Mm-hmm. All right. What else we got, Jeffrey? You got some headlines?
Let's get into the headlines. And actually, one place that would be awesome to do a live podcast, and obviously we're not committing to this because we have to talk to people, would be E3.
Oh, would you like to go to E3? That's
right.
That
would be fun.
In fact, not only could we do it at E3, but have you seen the news?
Have you seen
the news, Laura? We're going to be.
I've not seen the news.
We're going to
E3. Me.
Well, Jeffrey.
Well, in a what I feel like is a really fun and appropriate move, Xbox's E3 presence will be centered at the Microsoft Theater.
Yeah.
Which is it's really just, if you know the LA Live area, a stone's throw from the convention center, like literally like across Chick Hearn Street or whatever it's called.
Oh, it's about 50 feet behind the Marriott.
Yeah, yeah. So it's which is good for a lot of the people ended up staying there. So it's a wonderful facility. I got to visit down there during the Game Awards.
I was there for the Game Awards.
Yes,
too.
I know. It's a huge stage. I think that will empower like more people to come be in our briefing. But you know, it's essentially going to be our booth as well. And then we're going to, of course, have a booth in the convention center, and that'll be focused on Mixer.
Yep.
So we're going to be in more places than ever.
Yeah, it's going to be great to be at the Microsoft Theater. As Jeff said, we were down there for the Game Awards. I don't know if you know this theater, Laura. This is a world class theater. I mean, it is. That's right. I think they have the Grammy Awards there.
Really?
BET's, the BET Awards.
Yeah,
there.
I mean, this is like legit.
So why is it called a Microsoft Theater?
Because we have naming rights.
Okay.
It's kind of like, why is it called Century Field? Or
so is it always called Microsoft Theater?
It used to be called Nokia, okay. And then we bought Nokia, and then apparently part of that deal, we got phones and names. So I think, I don't actually know all the details, but that's what it seems like.
So it's called the Microsoft Theater outside of E3.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
That I was unclear on, but
yes.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah. If you go look, you'll see. There's a lot going on with the Microsoft Theater, so
and I know it's just a wonderful facility. It's just really nice. So I'm very excited to see what we do with it.
Can't wait to see what my green room looks like.
Will there be green M&Ms?
No. Anyway, so excited about that. What else you got there, Jeff?
All right. So we were talking about PUBG and we were talking about Fortnite, and actually news on both sides there. PUBG has now reached 5 million players on Xbox One.
That's
wow. Crazy. The game only came out in December.
December.
Not even 4 months.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, we are 3 of those 5 million people. So just multiply us by another 1.6 million, and that's how many people are playing. That's pretty great.
We had a great interview with Nico, who works on the Microsoft side of the project.
Yeah.
So go ahead and take a look at that on Inside Xbox. Go take a look at that interview, and you'll see Jeff and I. He talks about the roadmap coming up, things coming up for it. Yeah, there's a lot going on.
And the literal map, because you pulled that out of your pocket.
I did. I had a real live map, Laura, of Erangel.
How big was the map?
It was. Oh, I've got it right here, actually.
You got it in your bag?
I do.
Do you carry it around with you?
He does, in case he should happen to be in like Milta
at a moment
randomly.
Notice.
Yeah. So here it is, Laura. Here's the map.
It's like a map that you would pick up at a visitor center,
right?
You know, when you're on vacation
when
and
you're
you
on holiday,
figure out.
When you're going to Disney or Universal, that's the theme park.
Like Disney Gatka, which is opening up.
There is no gift shop and there is no restroom, Laura. You're on your own.
Yeah, there is just, you know,
there's
painkillers left all over the place.
School.
But it's made of the material that you would expect a high quality, like waterproof map.
Yes. So anyway, if you want to see that map, just go tune into the VOD of Inside Xbox. You'll see me pull it out of my pocket.
That's really funny. Cool.
So we did talk about Fortnite Battle Royale and some big news that came out earlier this week, and that is Xbox cross-platform play.
Woo-hoo!
Is coming to Fortnite.
Woo-hoo!
So people playing on Xbox One will also be able to play against people on PC, mobile, which is coming out, and there will also be progression. So presumably the way this would work out would be like, you're playing at home on Xbox One, you're leveling up your character, unlocking stuff, but then you can play mobily or you can play on your laptop.
I must say, I'm really enjoying this is because Laura's trying to fold the map here.
It's not easy.
It is not
how many
easy.
Engineers does it take to fold them out.
Definitely not in half.
And I can see her looking, using her analytic mind to try to, how does this go together?
I don't want to, you know if you fold the map wrong and...
Well, you just did. It's inside out.
It's inside out. You can ruin it. And this is a nice, quality piece of
swag. Not anymore.
I try not.
Not
to.
With all the folds going the wrong way, my friend.
I apologize.
No, don't bend it like that.
So it's not intuitive.
Give it to me.
You're there. You got it. She's got it. I think maybe. All right, you don't have it.
No.
So this week coming up is one of my favorite events of the year, which is GDC, the Game Developers Conference.
Oh. Yes, I did it.
Thank you.
Laura. Look at that. Wonderful.
There is tape on it, by the way. Somebody else folded it wrong.
A++.
GDC, Game Developer Conference.
So it's always just a good time because you run into developers from all over the world and you end up having like good conversations. And everyone's not as sort of worked up as they are at E3. But something that we've done for the last 4 years at GDC is have this ID at Xbox sort of reveal media event. And we've announced, and this is on Xbox Wire, I linked out to it in the show notes, 17 new games coming via the ID at Xbox program.
Cool.
Now, you'll look at it and you'll be like, I don't recognize any of these games, but that's kind of how it works. Like at this point, very likely, it's the first time you've heard of any of them. The only one that really jumped out at me as being super familiar was Black Desert, which we announced, I want to say, at E3 last year. But these are games that undoubtedly, 6 months from now, a year from now, whatever it might be, you're going to be like, oh my God, this game is like a indie game I'm super looking forward to. Like, I think we had Cuphead at this thing at one point. And so this is where we'll get an idea of what's good. I'm going to be down there. I'm going to play these games. And, how about next show? We talk about which ones I think you should be looking
for. I would like
to.
Unfortunately, I'm not going and Laura's not going. Actually, you're not going, are you? I don't want to speak for you. I'm not able to go this year, but
Starbound's coming. Yes. All right. Well, that's a cool game. Anyway, Super Meat Boy Forever. There's some familiar names. There's actually a lot of names. Anyway, you can check out the Lake Wargroove. I really want to play this. It's like,
I need a full report back.
All right. I'll tell you all about it. Yeah. Right. It's sort of like, all right, well, we'll talk about it later. Anyway, this was interesting coming out to, which is now available actually for pre-order and pre-download on Xbox One. I just thought it was interesting. The Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy.
Yep.
Insane.
Xbox.
Yeah. I mean, why not?
Why not?
Those were
up is down,
games
down
going
is up.
Up.
Who knows what's going on?
Here's another thing that happened this week. Actually, speaking of next week, so yeah, GDC, other thing I'm really looking forward to is, by the way, Sea of Thieves. Have you heard of it?
Oh, I have.
Coming out on the 20th.
I have.
And we'll, of course, be playing. I should bring my laptop down so
yeah,
I can play.
We can do cross-play.
You. All right. I will do that. But in honor of that, we, of course, did the very predictable and rational thing that you would expect any marketing, campaign to do for a game. We launched a man out of a cannon for a world record distance in Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, where at first I was like, why are we in Tampa? And then I realized every time they score a touchdown, they have a pirate ship there. They are the Buccaneers. Yes. And they fire a cannon, which is super loud, by the way. Mm. If you ever read a game, you don't sit near the cannon. Anyway, it was successful. I watched it live. I'm not going to lie. My heart was in my throat when this happened. Like when they started counting down, I'm like,
right. What
is going? I mean, this is risky stuff, And when he was in the air, he was flapping like a bird. Of course, he had no wings, which is a, a bit of a problem.
You can go watch the
when
DVD.
You're that hard. You should watch it.
I mean,
I've linked
probably,
out to
it's
it.
It's probably an animated GIF for Pete's sake.
Oh,
I'm
my
so
God.
Quick.
Yeah. I've linked out to it, but it was pretty impressive. And they did set the world record. This is probably my favorite news that came out this week. It was something I did not expect.
Better than a human cannonball breaking a record? How can that be?
Because it's just that good. Earlier this week, The Witcher or CD Projekt Red tweeted something about Cara Morin. And we're like, I thought they were done with The Witcher. Didn't they say they weren't going to be doing The Witcher anymore? Geralt in Soul Calibur 6.
Yeah!
And they released a trailer. It was today when we're recording this. And I got chills watching this trailer. It's so good. Like
link in the show notes.
Yes, link is in the show notes. But it's like, Soul Calibur is a game I've always enjoyed since the first one on Dreamcast. But I am so hyped for this now because they've historically put a lot of characters from other places in, but Geralt is going to be he just fits
it's
the
a voice
of it.
He's got we've seen his some of his moves are from the game
exactly
and
he's
set.
Got his signs anyway it's awesome you should watch it another big reveal this week as well was the announcement of Shadow of the Tomb Raider it's just about 20 seconds of footage
so it was an announcement of an upcoming announcement right
yes well okay. But we have a release date which means the game is coming September 14th of this year. So as folks, we enjoyed the Tomb Raider reboot. We enjoyed Rise of the Tomb Raider. Mm-hmm. It's the same team. So I'm sure we'll
do the math, people.
Of the Tomb Raider. It's going to be good.
Yeah.
So once again, linked out to the show notes there. A couple real quick points. Super Hot. Have you not played it? No excuse, because it's free right now with gold.
No super way. Hot.
Just go get it. It's waiting hot. For you.
Super.
That is a really hot. Fun game.
It's really fun in VR too.
And then
you had a chance to play it in VR.
So I did, and it is phenomenal. Yes, it's really good. And then just a couple of games that came out. This was actually a pretty good release week. One, Pure Farming 2018. Larry,
I
know
that. I think I played that.
Oh, goodness.
I bet you have. The Devil May Cry HD Collection. I know a lot of DMC fans out there. And this one, it was something that we talked about at on Inside Xbox, Surviving Mars. This game looks really good. A lot of the same folks that worked on City Skylines.
We showed that on Inside
we did.
Xbox,
that's
right?
Yeah. We just said, Larry, oh my God.
Hey, didn't we show that Inside Xbox?
No, you're hallucinating. Okay. Anyway, Surviving Mars looks really good. So I'll be jumping on that. That comes out this week. And then Burnout Paradise Remastered. That was a game that everyone got really excited about. I think it was trending worldwide when it was first announced. And if you have EA Access, you can just jump in and try it out.
Go.
Just go.
Go.
Why are you listening? Just go. Yeah, do it.
Press pause, go download.
Yes.
Go
play. And we're going to press pause on the news because that is it.
That's it. That's it. No, there's all that. Those are the headlines.
A lot. I am out of breath. I need to go have oxygen now.
Well, there's a lot more going up. You can just go over to my blog at majornelson.com. You can find me at Major Nelson. We're going to do, this show is kind of a little bit abbreviated. Jeff has to run. In a few minutes.
Oh, really?
I've got 15.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. We're good.
Oh, I just, no, I know. We're always running around.
I'm out of breath and I have to run. It's terrible.
So we've got, we talked about just some of the housekeeping rules. We've got PAX coming up, which we will not be doing a show, but we will have, Jeff and I will be on site doing a bunch of stuff. We'll have, of course, the Xbox booth will be there. Now, I know you're probably not too disappointed because last time we went to PAX, Laura, it was a little chilly.
It was really
remember?
Cold.
I remember
it was snowing.
I think I still have some of those texts you sending me when the plane landed. You go, about how cold it was.
Okay, this is bringing back memories that I was hoping to bury,
yeah,
but
sorry.
I was stuck on the runway
reheating
for
them.
Hours.
That's right.
Oh, that's right.
Right. Even in Boston, even at Logan. Yeah.
And I was stuck on the runway at Boston.
Right.
I was like, come on, guys, you're used to this, right?
Right. And then...
After a 6-hour flight.
Or after a 6-hour, the last thing you want to do is spend any more time on it.
Yeah, I remember that.
So anyway, we'll do that in Inside Xbox. Keep an eye on my blog and my Twitter for what the dates are for those. All right, let's do a name the game. Do you want to do this? Now, the last name the game we did was video.
That's right. We did a video name the game last time.
Yes, which we played during the live show. That was a live show.
Yep.
And so we pulled the audio out and put it on here. So there were some people that used the extra images to guess right. So you want to go ahead and roll that to remind people?
Let's do the payoff here. So this is the sound effects from last time's Name the Game. Name the game from last time, and it was Soma, which is a space game.
Yep.
And of course, the people who watched either the live mixer cast or the
or rewatched
demand,
it in VOD, yeah,
video on demand afterwards, got the extra help to guess that.
Mm-hmm.
But this time we have a random winner from the many responses we got that were correct.
Yep.
And the winner this week is Tim from Iowa.
Oh, hi, Tim.
Yep. And his gamer tag is Comb Filtered.
What did he win?
Tim, we have lots of
Do you think that's a rooster reference? Because isn't that what they call the thing that goes over their head, a comb?
Yeah. I was thinking like cores, it's comb filtered, but maybe.
Oh, maybe.
Cold filter. I don't know.
Well, Tim, if you want to send us an email about your gamer tag, we're confused.
That tells a lot about each of us. I'm curious what you think it is.
You were thinking of chickens and you were thinking of
It's 1:06 p.m. I'm ready to, I'm ready.
Oh, very good. So, Tim, you've won a lot of games here. You've won a copy of Soma. You've won a copy of Train Sim World Founders Edition.
I played it.
It sounds pretty fun.
Mm-hmm.
So, Tim, you'll get to play this wonderful train game, too. You also get a copy of The Darwin Project, which you talked about earlier.
Yeah,
in the podcast.
A lot of fun.
Get a copy of Life is Strange Before the Storm.
Ooh, you love that
edition.
One.
I really loved Life is Strange. It's a really good story.
Yep.
You also get a copy of Scribblenauts Showdown.
Scribblenauts now on Xbox.
Exactly. That's not all.
No.
We're going to give you a copy of Pure Farming 18.
Fun.
Yes.
And a copy of Burnout Paradise Remastered.
Woo!
So a good game haul.
Wow.
For you,
Tim.
What
a variety.
Excellent work.
Lots
so
of, lots of games.
For those of you just tuning in, you're wondering how you get in on the winning, Laura's going to tell you now.
That's exactly right. If you too would like to win a lot of fabulous prizes, all you have to do is listen to some sound effects I'm about to play. And then send us an email with what game you think those sounds are from.
Now, it's going to be a little harder this week because you don't have the visuals of a live show to go back and take a look at. You're welcome to listen to this as many times as you want, but we're not giving you visuals this time.
That's right. So, all right, so let's roll the sound effects. Right, so those are the sounds, and if you think you know what game those sounds are from, send us an email, lollipop@xbox.com and ccmajor@xbox.com. It's that easy. It's pretty good, pretty easy. And I have lots of questions on Twitter about who can enter this contest. Who can enter this contest?
Well,
it's really, really simple.
Yep.
If you can hear our voice,
yep,
you can enter this game.
Simple as that.
Simple as that.
Yeah,
unless you work for Microsoft.
Yeah, unless you work for Microsoft or... Yeah,
either. And
don't do that.
A reminder, please send us email. We don't take entries over Twitter.
Mm-hmm. Email or over
only.
Xbox Live.
Yeah, or messages on Xbox Live, exactly.
Right.
Please send us email. And only one, please. Don't
yeah,
send more than one
per person.
One per person.
And good luck.
That's right.
Good luck. Woo. All right, where were we?
Good luck on your brackets, by the way.
That would be, so that's a reference Jeff is making to the college football games that are happening.
Really? Football, Larry?
No.
Was that on purpose or not? You never know with this guy.
No, it was college basketball.
Go Gators!
So college basketball, I know that. So for there's a lot of people outside the country that we have an international listenership. They may not know what that means.
But everyone knows the international language of workplace gambling. And that's what brackets.
That's are. Not what we're doing. That's
no,
not what we're
no,
doing.
No, that's not. I don't know if that's not Jeff. It may or may not be legal. I don't know. But
at Jeff Rubenstein on Twitter.
Yeah, the complaint desk. I'm just saying all of the orange and blue, all of the orange teams will be rooting for.
Yes.
I don't know if Texas.
That's
is.
Right. We all went to
we
the
all
orange schools.
Went to orange schools.
Wearing, yep. Oh, Texas. They're a number 10 seed. Syracuse has an 11 seed and the Gators are 6 seed. So
we're actually really close.
Let us all get in there. Let's all get in the final four.
But I like how you are color coordinated today.
Oh.
You're wearing orange
Hold
and
up.
Blue. Oh my goodness.
Look at those.
And the socks are also
See, now
orange
that's
and
that's
blue.
That orange top you have on, that sweatshirt. That's kind of UT
that's
orange.
It is
Texas
a little it's faded.
Orange.
It's more of a Texas orange, but you can't
pick
it's
oh, there
faded.
It.
It's burnt.
I got my shirt. And I went all out today.
Oh my goodness. His shirt has UF on it.
Could you put that down again? Why is there
a
Seattle?
A Seattle
why is there space
for the Seattle Gator Club?
Oh.
And so the top of the U in
yes.
UF
yes.
is the Space Needle.
That's right.
That's what we do. That's
or nice. Is my wife can never remember the name of it.
The Space Needle?
Yeah.
Or Florida?
No, the Space Needle. She always calls it Skycap.
Like the people that take your
I don't
suitcase?
Know. I don't know. She always calls it Skycap. You know what else? I hate. I mean, I don't. I love my wife. She's so funny. She can't remember the name of Godzilla.
Mm-hmm.
So she knows she calls it Tokyo Dinosaur.
I suppose
that's
not inaccurate.
That's not inaccurate. So Tokyo
that's
Dinosaur. It's
possible.
Right. I'm like,
yeah.
You know what? You're right, honey. So, all right. So name the game. What else do we have to go over this time? We kind of go over some new stuff we have in our life. Do you have anything?
What do you? Just crushing sorrow and loneliness.
Oh, that's not true.
No,
that's not true.
I mean, no more. It's not new.
No.
That just made me feel sad.
I shouldn't have said that.
No. I don't know. I don't. Yeah, Nella.
I don't know. It just sort of came out of my mouth, which is what we're used to. Maybe I have been drinking the cold filtered at 106.
You need
I have
more
not.
Of that. It
no,
like.
It's
well, I am looking
water.
To get a new laptop. But
yeah.
Nothing to share at the moment.
Yeah.
I'm on the market.
You need some new hardware.
New
I've actually got a new one coming in. I can't talk about it yet because it's it's TBD.
That's exciting.
Right?
You always get the good stuff.
Well, you know,
I spend a lot of money because of you.
It's thank you. But it's all, I'll share that in a future show. Yeah. Next month, as I said, we've got PAX, which will be at no show. We've got the live show and then you guys are welcome to a show, but I'm going to be off the last half of April.
Right.
So be dealing
Maybe
on holiday.
We'll stream.
I'll be off on holiday.
Oh, you're on holiday. Okay. Jeff, you're on your own.
I'm on my own.
Jeff.
Party one. About that crushing loneliness. You're not helping.
Rubenstein party of one. Would you like? Because I don't know. So it's funny because I travel a lot by myself for business. Yeah. I know Jeff, you do. Laura, you travel by yourself. Mm-hmm. But there's nothing more depressing than when you go into like a restaurant. Oh, one. Would you like to sit at the bar?
Yeah.
No, I don't want to sit at the bar.
I'm just like, can you just put me in view of a TV so I, you know, don't have to remember that I'm by myself?
I think at this point I've embraced eating by myself and actually enjoy it.
Oh, yeah. I don't get me wrong. I enjoy it as well. But it's just, it's like, no, I don't want to sit at the bar. I want to go sit somewhere else. Anyway, I don't know why.
You like a good view.
Cranky on
this is what happens when you travel and I'm not there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Bring me with you to meet famous people. We've done that.
All right. Listen, I'm going to let you guys go. You listeners, I'm going to let you go. Laura, you're going to get to work. Jeff, you're going to get to your next appointment on time.
Yeah.
You can follow us on Twitter. Laura, how do they find you?
At Laura Lollipop.
And then Jeffrey.
All complaints to you at Jeff Rubenstein.
Yes. And CC at Major Nelson if you'd like, but you don't have to. Mm-hmm. So you can also find me other places as well. Anyway, we'll be back. We may be back next week. We'll have probably a longer show next week. I've got a couple things I'm working on. Always working on something, Jeff.
You are.
Oh, you're a busy man.
And then we'll hopefully, yes.
And we'll have Sea of Thieves to talk about.
We'll have Sea of Thieves talk about.
Exciting.
Yeah, we're gonna do Sea of Thieves, and then we'll get ready for PAX and the march is on towards E3 at the Microsoft Theater. So if you want to catch all that news, just head over to news.xbox.com. All right, gang. We will talk to you next time. Say goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye, everybody.